The fact that most city roads are dilapidated is self-evident. Roads such as Salama, Portobello do have a lot of potholes that spoil motorist vehicles during the rain. They are riddled with potholes that cost them in terms of garage visits, accidents, and lots of time in traffic jam. We sit down with Simon Kasiate, the spokesperson of KCCA, Kampala Capital City Authority, to talk about city roads. Welcome. Motorists in Kampala are tired of the garage every day because of dilapidated roads. You have them making more visits when it rains because of the potholes that are filled with water and flooded roads, and yet they have to go through them. What is the problem? Why can't we have smooth roads?
We recognize as KCCA the dire state of our roads in Kampala, and just give it some perspective for you to appreciate the kind of road network that KCCA's current administration is dealing with. We're looking at 2,100 kilometers of roads, of which less than 30% are tarmac roads. So the rest are manam roads. So let's start from there. But even of the 600, close 700 kilometers of roads that have tarmac, many of them are more than 20 years old, meaning that they have, by all parameters, outlived their sell-by date. So we are dealing with a road network that has for the longest time not been replaced and has hit its sell-by date. And hence the situation we see today. It's not that we were waiting for them to grow this old and then we begin backfilling, but it's because there has been a consistent absence of enough financing to facilitate KCCA to do regular maintenance of these roads and also build new roads. However, here is the good news. From a recent acquisition of about $288 million, from African Development Bank, KCCA is embarking on what we call the Kampala City Roads Rehabilitation Project. This is a project that is going to restore unto this city close to 100 kilometers of refurbished, rehabilitated, and some newly constructed roads that are bigger and better than what we have at the moment. There are 5 lots of these works cut across and spread through the 5 divisions of Kampala. I'll just give you an example for illustration purposes. This project did, in fact, start in February of this year. That's when the works did begin. Unfortunately, when we say works began in February, the ordinary or an undiscerning eye of a Kampalan wants to see graders roaring, earthworks taking place, bitumen being spread on the road, all within the space of one day. But when we say works begin, it meant that contractors have been contracted. Works have therefore begun.
Let's talk drainage system. Does Kampala have a drainage system?
I wouldn't be in a comfortable position to discuss the sewage management of Kampala because that's not within the realm of KCCA.
Who is in charge when sewage tanks are left to overflow when it rains?
National Water and Sewerage Corporation. But I can also inform you that really the city's sewer system covers less than 30% of the city. So you only have areas such as the Central Business District, Nakasero, Kololo, I mean Bugolobi, I think parts of Nagu and old Kampala that are part of the central sewer system. The rest of all of us in Kampala are disposing our effluent on site. In other words, either using pit latrines or septic tanks.
Why isn't the road infrastructure in the CBD improving at the same rate that matches the needs or demands of the city dwellers?
3 reasons. Number 1, money. Number 2, money. Number 3, money.
Simon, does the authority have empathy for motorists whose vehicles get damaged due to bad roads?
I'll tell you what. What we have in this place is empathy, and that's what keeps us awake, that we are superintending over a city where citizens or folks that come to the city as either commuters, workers, or residents feel heavily inconvenienced, feel terribly disturbed by the state of our roads. And that's why we're making a clarion call to the government to give us more financing. That's why we're going out to look for smart financing options with development agencies. That's why we are going out to carry out partnerships with companies such as Qualas of the United Kingdom, where we now currently have an MOU, to try and see how we can put our hands together, put all hands on deck, to ensure that the situation of bad roads in the city is sorted.
When you host visitors, do you feel proud of the city roads?
Let me say that pride in our city should not be a preserve of KCCA. All of us, KCCA or private people, it's important and incumbent on all of us to ensure that we have a city that we are all proud to have. Let each one of us do their part. Don't litter, don't vandalize, do your part as a private citizen, and let KCCA face the brunt of management and organization squared without excuse.
Thank you, Simon. That has been the week's News Digest. Until next week, Vivian, come see me.